Hello again, everyone. We're following up straight from where we left off. The excursions are chased off, and we are now just, well, picking up the pieces, so to speak, and eventually returning to Yamato to, well, celebrate, I would assume. Let's do that very thing. And, you know, if they ever translate and dub this game, or the anime, I just know Yachtval is going to be voiced by Matt Mercer. Well, this is odd, actually. About her ears. I think they often use that in, at least video game character design. Well, ears and hair, at least if you count Fire Emblem. Ears in this game. It's special in that way, at least, to mark some sort of relation. I don't remember off the top of my head, but doesn't Kiru have ears like this? Wonder if they are related in some way. And Antoa recognizes him. Actually, let's look at that real quick. If we could. Never mind.
これ以上の面倒事は願い下げなんだよ。まして、怪我とか
Yeah, fuck with the lazy bum. That's fair. Okay. So, I guess this is where we save the game. Any new glossary entries? Yes, now we have an entry for Antua. Okay, doesn't really say anything about Kiru. Not Kamui. No, okay. He has dark ears, fading to white, not white ears fading to dark. My bad. What is this Nakamura place, though? Huh. Would be interesting if they were, all from the same place. But I guess we don't know. Just a little side note here. The menu background you saw at the beginning of the video, I believe that is actually unlocked when we go on this little adventure. So I think I may have given this video a very inaccurate title. Yeah, well, we'll see. Let's keep going. Oh, Hawk. God. Unethical little lazy sleaze bag. I guess Hawk would be called a simp on today's internet. You are drunk, Mr. Man. Hawk, that would not have ended well. You know that. All you nerds, I just had an idea here. Maybe Kuan came here for the explicit purpose of finding ruins like this to search for her father. We don't know what she has heard about him or what she has not heard about him. Her excitement makes me think they might be suggesting that. I don't think under the circumstances that it would be appropriate to just be all smiles about it, but I don't know. Maybe I'm just straight up mistaken. That could be, that is also very possible. I saw that coming. Okay, so these guards are definitely connected to the Imperial Court. Good to know. Okay, I guess I spoke too soon. Never mind. Okay, so about Kuon's speech pattern, adding "I think" to her sentences so often. In the anime adaptation of this, you might think that this game is a video game adaptation for an anime, but it's actually the other way around. I found that they exaggerated this verbal tic just too much. Well, in the anime, I thought she didn't do this nearly as often in the game, but she kind of does do it a lot. Well, anyway, I think it is high time to end the episode, so I'm going to do that, and I don't know, go and visit the recycling station or something. And see you in the next episode. Stay tuned.